Can you guys hear me? Testing this thing. Hello, Judge Judy Slayer. Thank you for the follow. We're not yet even on there, but I just saw it pop up in my Streamlabs, so I appreciate it. Okay, good. By any chance, can you hear my music? Because I'm having some minor difficulties getting that going. Hello, Mr. Frike. Like, what's happening is it... Okay, you can hear it? That's good. Because I have this little Momo bouncing, and for whatever reason, it's making it so I can't hear my music coming out of my headphones, but if you guys can hear it, that's really all that matters. And same with, like, the VOD, I guess. So, let's get this switched over. Nice, that works. Apparently my Spotify still isn't showing up there. Like I said, it's been really weird, so let's see if that works. Okay, that should be good. It's showing up on my screen now. And shows up on my stream on Twitch as well, so that's good. Alright, well, as long as all of that's working for you guys, and you can hear music, then we're pretty much good to go. You will be hearing my dehumidifier a lot in the background. It is supposed to be raining, and it's been humid all day. There it goes again. So welcome back. Another week of kit building, another Tuesday. Today is the 31st, and as you can see from the agenda, we will be hair shading today. So previously on the last stream, we worked on hair. We got all the hair masked up on that little face, and we just laid down the base coat. We didn't have much more time other than that, so today we're going to spend time shading the hair and getting it to the color we really want it to be. Hope you're doing okay. I am, thank you. I'm back in school at this point. This is the first week, so it's already crazy. I feel like I've studied more in the past 2 days and done more than I have in like over a year. So we'll see how this continues going. Tuesday streams, I might not need to, or I might need to switch it to another day, because I'm finding even now on like the first week of school, my Tuesdays are really busy because Wednesday is like all of my classes and all the deadlines. So moving forward, we'll see how it goes, but just kind of gonna update you guys as it goes along. And yeah, no problem, Rebel Star. I'm very happy to help. I know it's a new kind of terrain, and forwarding can be kind of scary to get things set up. I felt the same way when I first started, so I'm glad that you are able to do so, and hope you get the kit that you want. But yeah, so what we will be doing today is mostly hair shading. I have this spoon right here, which I have been kind of testing the colors that I want to use on it. As you can see, this was the base color we laid down, and this is kind of the final color I want her hair to end up being. So, very Chun-Li-ish. Not sure if I'll like fully stick with it, because sometimes the spoon colors change, or looks different compared to when you lay the hair color down, but this basically follows the method that I had wanted to use. So we're going to start with that and see kind of where it goes. As you can see here, the pieces are the same color as this spoon here, because that's just the base tone that we laid down. So we've got 4 pieces that we'll need to shade and work on. Let me zoom out a little bit. You can see my writing here. So we got these 2 hair pieces. We've got a really tiny hair, which I will have to put back on a piece of tape, and a head piece. So this is her head that was all, masked up last time, and this time today we'll be shading it. So let's see. Also, there's like a big glare on my laptop. Sorry. There we go. Okay. Yeah. So her base hair tone is all laid down, but you can see it's pretty different from this one. So really the goal will be to get this hair looking more chocolatey, darker tones, because once you look at the painting reference, which let me make bigger, you can see Chun-Li's hair is actually much darker than this base color we have laid down. So looking at the spoon color, it's a little bit closer to what we want here. And yeah, that's what we're gonna aim for today. So hopefully
Well, I don't see any reason why we wouldn't get the hair shading done today. It might take a bit of time, depending on how, you know, much time I want to spend on it, if I can get it right the first time, etc. So we'll start out with that. Let me put these back. And I just remembered I did not even change out my airbrush, and I need to make this smaller, so. Lots of management stuff going on here. Make this smaller. Or make, yeah, make that smaller, change my airbrush out to my smaller airbrush, and then we'll go through that. And I was looking at the VOD from last time, and it looked like this angle worked really well, although I did notice when I kind of put my airbrush down, it would tend to focus, like, only on the airbrush again. So I'm going to try to do this at an angle, but not really sure how much more I can do beyond that. So we'll play it by ear. Back going. Very odd not hearing my music. I'm usually listening to something in the background. Okay. So yeah, this is the base color. This is the one we're going to aim for. So really this is just a combination of a mid-tone and then a bunch of colors I have laying here. Mostly clear browns, some blacks, and a red. But all of that will kind of vary as we're working on the kit. So put this over here. Hopefully you guys can still see. Just gonna test that out. Okay. So let's get this going. Oh yeah, I also need to open my window. I have not too much time to prepare because I was out.
Oh, sorry if you heard that. It was my head hitting the mic. I'm so cramped in this setup here. Now that it's like standing up, I don't have much room at all. Anyway, I was saying I don't have much time. Yeah, I'm okay. I just lightly bopped it. Thank you for asking. I was saying I don't have much time because I was reading my textbook like 20 minutes before I was supposed to start the stream. So, good sign of things to come. I also moved the mic a little bit closer though, in case you guys can't hear me. Okay, let's get this mid-tone going. So this is the color we'll be using. This is just labeled hair mid-tone. It's based off of a mixture that we made before. So hair mid-tone. It was like some white, some orange, bunch of droppers of black, etc. Definitely more of a browner, chocolatier tone compared to the light tone, which was more like red focused. So you can see the difference here. So laying this one down will change the color pretty drastically. And I'm gonna go kind of slow because I don't want it to spray too much. And I do want to focus on shaded areas and stuff. So let's get some of that in the airbrush. And I'm gonna test this on a spoon as always before. That's why I have this other base tone spoon. Oh wait, never mind. Thought my camera wasn't working. Okay. Yeah, that Munchkin kit is super cute. I love Munchkin's work. I own many of his kits. Undecided currently if I want to try for that Halloween one, just because his stuff sells out almost instantaneously. So my biggest advice for you would be to follow him very closely. Follow when he posts that booth link, because it might sell out within the hour. That's my only advice there.
All right. Putting this back on, and we are going to start. Let's see, what should we start with? Let's start with the light hair piece or the small one. So I'm just gonna put this hair on. Yeah, it's okay if you post the link. She's very sweet and pretty, you know, she's safe for work, so it's fine. And I'm a big fan of Munchkin models. I have a couple of his stuff, so no problems there. It will probably at some point be resold as well if it's extremely popular, so it's just something else to keep in mind. Okay. Alright, so now I got that. And make sure this is, yep, zoomed in enough. Oh, that's that. Okay. So, let me change that. Alright, so we're going to start airbrushing.
As always, gonna shut off my sound just because, you know, it's loud. So. Alright, and if anything changes, if you can't hear my music, let me know. Again, Spotify's being weird this time, so yeah, I want to make sure you guys have a pleasant stream as well. quick transition, I'm just going to move over to working on these twin tails. And then last, I'm going to do the head. So we're going to do twin tails, head, and then make sure that the bangs match up with the head before continuing on and doing the next step. So even though this looks like it's already fully shaded, we've still got a long way to go. And a lot of clear colors and smoothing out to put on, so. Just kind of over the FYI. I'm gonna add a little bit more sugar and some more over as well. Alright, yeah, thank you, RoboStar. We're moving on. You may also notice me using this at some point. This is the melanine sponge I was talking about, so. It's just a thinly cut sponge, and it can wipe off pretty quickly if you make a mistake, if you like have paint splatter. So, because we laid down this base coat so long ago, it's already had a chance to cure. So, you're able to basically wipe off this darker paint layer quickly before it cures onto that surface. So, that's what I will be doing at some point. not the most interesting stuff, but you know, it is what it is. So let me see real quick. You can see that this color has darkened considerably, and we've tried to put some emphasis on just, you know, shadows, and so really got some pretty thick shading along here, along the hair tip, down here, and yeah, kind of just along the whole thing in certain places, and so I'm going to make sure and see that it's okay. Come on, really can, it really just wants to focus on the towel. It's kind of an okay angle, so you can see that some areas are super dark, others aren't. I might go in here real quick actually and shade a little bit farther in. I think there's a side from it. Let me see if I can do that right now actually. Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, so yeah, today really is just gonna be shading and doing the color how I want it, because it's kind of the last thing that we're gonna do before we start detailing. So all the time here is really just such an awkward piece to handle as well, so, you know, there's a lot of different ways that this can be shaded, and so you may have noticed me kind of putting the paper towel under pieces, and that's so I don't spray, you know, the tendril below, so if I don't want this one to be like, oh, sorry, if I don't want this one to be a darker brown, and I'm gonna like put the paper towel under like this, and so on and so forth. So, just a technique that I'm using. For me. So we'll come back to it, and we're going to switch over to the other hair tendril now. And I'm going to need a little bit of paint, so I'm going to just go. Okay. I should clean this up too. I did notice that the paint was a little kind of spotty at some point, so I'm just going to give it a quick clean up. And I'll fill in it as well. Oh, is audio not, desktop audio not working now? Yeah, it looks like it paused. There we go. Wait, not reading it? Yeah, there we go. Wait, no. Seems like it's going. Hopefully. Alright, let me get some more thinner. I think the good news is that hair tendril was the more complicated one too. So even if this is the next one we're painting. This one looks a little bit bigger, but most of the pieces are kind of like separate and they wind around, so it'll be a little bit easier to shave them. Whereas this one has multiple places where it kind of like goes in and back out, and so not quite as easy. So we're going to focus on this hair piece next, and then after that I'll probably briefly pause and then we'll move into her hair. So her back of her hair, navel, her neck, etc. And then I'll compare all of these, make sure that I like the shadings on them before we move on to the next step of shading. There are multiple steps.
Thank you.
another really brief gap of the transition into the hair on her head. So what I will also be doing is once we are done with this head, we're going to go back to my Iwata airbrush, and then I will be covering the hair again with this mid-tone mixture. The point two is really just more for like the detail work and getting the fine kind of spirals, but then I kind of want to longer coat the piece really quick with this mid-tone mixture. So next up, and what I'll be doing shortly now, is defining these creases in her hair using a combination of my airbrush and this melanin sponge. So basically we're going to do all the shading and then kind of like rub stuff away. And if we do it right, all of the shadings will kind of get stuck in between the hair pieces here, like the hair gaps. So there's some wiggle room, and we'll see what effect we get. Alright, let me jump right into that and show how we need to paint and check how it looks. And a little bit more cleaner. But otherwise, pretty good to go. So, alright. I'm going to turn this compressor up. And let's get this going. Thank you.
Larger needle size, and it will just like blend it all. And then after that, I'm going to directly go into applying the light color again. And so, usually I'm not shading with opaques, but because Chun-Li's hair is so dark, I needed to apply that mid-tone color. Applying a light color, even if it's, you know, the same brown as before, over the darker color will kind of make it less saturated. It'll look like a more gray version of the paint. And so this, although it looks pretty dark now, will look more grayish in tone and not quite as vibrant. And so what we're gonna do after that is apply a series of clear colors to really bring back that darkness and make it, you know, a nice vibrant brown. And so even now, you know, these colors are not super vibrant, they're kind of washed out. There's a couple like weird spots on them that I need to work on some more. So we're gonna do, you know, some overall TLC to these pieces. But first we will apply the mid-tone with my Iwata, which should be good. I already forgot if I put paint in here and checked it. Yeah, we're good. Okay, so let's get that mid-tone going. Making good time, we should be able to finish all of these pieces tonight, so that will leave tomorrow for clear coating, and then Thursday we should be able to start some detail work. So we're very rapidly approaching the end of this kit. Face will be the main thing. We might even dive straight into painting the face. So we'll see how it goes. Alright, let me get my mask back on. So I was talking to you guys for a moment. But actually, first, let me get a drink, and then I will continue. All right.
Compressor is back on, and we're going to turn on again. Getting rid of the shading, we're just kind of lightly coloring this. hard button. Alright, that was nice and quick, so really not too much needed there. Just wanted to give it a light dusting to blend everything together. So let me get this out of the airbrush and then I'll show you guys the pieces. And after that, we're going to transition into cool colors. So,
take off my mask as well so you guys can hear me a little better. So yeah, majority of my shading is done with clear colors. Sometimes, you know, I go in with an opaque color like this, but clear colors allow you to get, you know, deeper shadings and intensify things as much as you want. And I usually don't see as much like splashback or like tiny dots when I'm using clear colors, so for that reason I prefer them. But when you need, you know, darker colors like this, or really strong highlights, etc., I usually use a combo of opaque and clear techniques. So, let's throw this away. Alright, so let's just take a look real quick at the pieces. You can see here that the shadings are kind of grayed out at this point, so, you know, we have this strong brown, and but then it looks kind of gray, and not very browny. Not very pleasant to look at. So we're gonna attempt to fix that. This is all intentional, with some clear colors that will bring back the color and make it look a little bit more vibrant. So our end result is closer to this rather than, you know, this brown. Hard kind of, you can see the difference here. One is more gray and one is definitely a richer chocolate brown. So
other hair pieces. This one's more or less the same. You can see that it has nice shadings, but it just is kind of grayed out and not very nice. Also wondering how much of an effect is from blushing from tonight because it's so humid, but I don't think it contributes that much, and if so, I'll just apply a little bit of some thinner at the end to kind of get rid of that whitish cast. Alright, so let me look at my instructions here. Looks like our first step is going to be using GX109. This is the clear brown. So I think, let's see if I can focus. Come on, clear brown. There we go. Mr. Clear Color GX Clear Brown, or blown. So Japanese can't really tell between L and R, so sometimes you get L's, which are supposed to be R's, and vice versa. But this is GX109. So this is a, I guess, I don't want to say brown toned brown. It's more of a yellow brown with some darker elements in it, as opposed to being like on the orange spectrum, like the Gaia Notes clear brown. But I am going to apply this first all over the pieces. They will have to undergo a series of clear treatments to get them to the kind of color that I want. I did already previously mix some of these, but they've kind of dried out, so I'll be using the same paint pot and just remixing and adding some clears into them. And we're not mixing clears, actually, we are, but we'll go into that later. But for this one, I'm just using the clear brown straight from the bottle, so no alterations necessary. Clean up a little bit around here too. Keep accidentally picking up the droppers. Alright, so this one is going to go all over the paint and the pieces, so let's do this. Okay, just have to orient myself. Yeah, Canon, that's my new addition. That's why my music is all messed up right now, including like right now. Let's see. Yeah, Momo's interfering with everything, but it's such a cute effect that I wanted it to work. Let's see. It relies on the Discord interface, and so Discord has issues with like listening to Spotify at the same time, and there's all sorts of connectivity things, so still working it out, but I'll have to check the VOD later and see. Alright, gonna mute myself again. This is the brown clear coat. Alright, leaving my compressor on, I'm going to pour out this brown, and I'm actually going to spray a little bit of thinner on these pieces. I think they are getting kind of a grayish cast on them, and so I want to make sure that I get that fixed, or at least, you know, kind of lessen the effect before we continue. So, just going to spray this with some pure, straight Mr. Color Leveling Thinner. That'll just kind of reactivate the pieces briefly and allow any moisture to escape. I didn't add retarder to any of this paint tonight, which I probably should. Maybe I'll do that for this clear brown that's coming up next, because that could be having an effect on it. So let's just do that real quick. I'm not even going to turn the booth on. I'm just going to quickly spray each piece. Oh god. Head just went flying, so. That's great. One moment, y'all. I don't know where that went. Oh. Okay. Got caught in my windowsill. Let's see if any paint scratched, though, as I shake this. Looks pretty good. The power of lacquer. Really, it just, like, dries pretty quick, and nothing scratches, so. Okay, so I'm just going to put a very quick coat of thinner on here. Yeah, that seemed to help a little bit, at least for that. Okay, let's do this real quick. Again, not spraying anything paint-related, just quickly giving these a coat of thinner to eliminate gray cast caused by moisture buildup. Some of that is just kind of a gray hint from laying on that lighter color. Okay. So now we're going to transition into Gaia Notes Clear Brown, which will really brighten up these pieces. It's a very strong brown in comparison to the GX109 I've found. And so this is Gaia Notes 046 Clear Brown. So again, much more orange toned. Even looking at these two bottles, you can see one is more orange and one is more like yellow brown toned, I guess. Let's add a little bit more in here. And since a little goes a long way with this, I think last time I just used half a dropper, so we'll see. I'm also going to add a little bit of retarder into this, just because I was noticing that cast happening. So far, so good though. From what I can see, I'm liking the brown color that's coming out here. I will be showing it next to the pants, so they're two very different colors at this point, which is exactly what we wanted. But we also wanted stronger shadings because this is a action-y kit, so it's relevant. Alright, yeah, I'm just going to add half a dropper here. That back. Okay, again, here's a comparison of Gaia Note, or not Gaia Notes, sorry, GX109 and Gaia Notes. You can see that this one here is basically orange toned, and yet it's still a little bit darker than the guy that's clear orange, so they are two very different colors. Okay, let's get that mask on. So these are also going to be an all over color, and then after that I'll evaluate kind of where we're at, because for this one, I think, yeah, after I applied that GX clear brown, or sorry, the Gaia Notes Clear Brown, I was mostly happy with the color, but I did need to go in with a little bit of red and black shading as well. So, things to do on the agenda. We're getting good though. You want to paint so bad. No time, right? That's where I'm getting to. If I did not set aside the time to do this, I would not be doing this tonight. I can tell you guys that much. I have so much to do. Seriously tempted to do a DIY airbrush. I don't know how that would work. Like, you mean make your own? Or are you talking about an air booth? Because the fans, yeah, fan filtration is a big issue for sure. Booth. Yeah, this one, I find that it kind of struggles after a while, and it does require cleaning the vent a lot. Also, the space, you're kind of limited, and so I think in the future I probably would like to upgrade, but for now, you know, I'm kind of limited by my space, and it does the job, so... I have seen some really cool custom builds. It seems like something relatively easy to make if you're handy. And so, yeah, I don't really have much space either. Like, I have this room, and I guess the room has a lot of space, but in terms of, you know, me being able to build a whole setup for it and whatnot, not really. Because my cat also shares the space. So it needs to be portable, it needs to be, like, safe so I can wash it and keep stuff away, etc. Tough stuff. Yeah, a lot of us don't have the luxury of having, you know, a whole dedicated basement or a room or whatever, and so, you know, you do what you can with the space you have. You gotta hand paint then, Canon. Did that and I didn't have to have much space at all. I remember doing that in college and I would just paint at my computer desk, so fun times. All right, let's get this clear brown on top of this kit.
No. It's good to hear you, though, or see you typing, I guess. But it feels like it's been a while, so hope you haven't been too busy. And again, we're hopefully busy at this point. And I put compressor on so and let's get this clear brown on. gonna leave this compressor on for one moment.
I'm gonna look at these pieces under my regular hobby light, because you get kind of this reddish light coming out of the ring light that's on my left here. So I wanna make sure that these pieces are where I like them. Leaving the compressor on. I think I already said that. But. First impressions is it is that nice chocolatey brown. It's pretty bright, honestly, which is both good and bad, I think, because the shadings are really dark against it. So let's see. Yeah, that's pretty nice. And let's look at this. Okay. Yeah, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to mix another clear color to kind of blend things together more. So let's get this off. So I think I'm going to do a kind of a darker brown this time. So I have that clear brown, but I'm going to add some clear black to another mixture. And then that one we can kind of apply to everything. And that'll deepen those shadings too and blend everything. Together. Oh, there we go. It's like, where did the camera go? So you can definitely mix clear colors as well. I do this quite often to make sure, you know, that the shadings are the right shade that I want. So let's start out with clear black. And I do need to add a little bit of retarder as well. Okay. How are you guys feeling about the stream times, by the way, at 8 p.m.? So if I, for example, if I wanted to stream earlier on Tuesdays, would you guys be able to make that? Would you prefer it? Let me know in the comments, because this current stream does run a little bit late according to my schedule now. And although I don't have class on Tuesdays, most of my reading and stuff is being done then. So I was considering making the time a little bit earlier so I'd be able to wrap up stuff in the night. Or if Tuesday doesn't work for you at all, also let me know, because there is also a strong possibility that I might just need to move Tuesdays to some other day, Sunday or something else. Yeah, for you for sure, Rebel Star. Bless you for staying up this late just to watch my humble stream. I really appreciate it. Yeah, I'm sure, like, if I began at like 1 p.m. my time or something, that would probably be better for you. I don't know if it'd be that early, but yeah. Okay, so yeah, it looks like I have a lot of European people, or people on a different time zone as well. So I will take that into consideration and maybe stream earlier or move it to another day, such as Sunday. We'll see. But yeah, Sunday might work okay. But then it kind of competes with everything else going on Sundays, so. Let's see, what's the decibel level of your spray booth? I'm actually not sure. Let me see if it is listed on the Amazon page that I got it from. It was really just kind of like a generic spray booth that I bought off of Amazon. Let's see, spray booth. Ooh, also this laptop is pretty toasty. Let's see, a lot of these are kind of the generic same-ish brand. Well, let's see what it says. If there is a decibel reading. I don't see anything about it on this listing. It does tell you like the
power it requires and the wattage of the lights. Oh wait, maybe this. No, yeah, I don't think there's anything about how loud the fan is, but I assure you that when you turn it on, it's quite loud and I need to mute myself, if that hasn't already been. Let's see. Okay. There is a review here. Okay, so the description, someone says they found it, says this particular airbrush booth was less than 47 decibels. But somebody did a measurement and they found that it was about 70 decibels. So that's quite loud. Let's see. That would be a vacuum cleaner. So, like, imagine a loud vacuum cleaner. Imagine a car at 65 miles an hour. That's kind of how loud it is. So, again, you know, and there's a lot of reviews here that say it's too loud. So, if fan noise is an issue, definitely would not consider getting this booth or investing in your own tech to do that. Let's see. Hello, Hololai. You're liking a later time and you're starting a new job. So, okay. So that's good to know too. Ooh, congrats on the new job, by the way. I wonder if all the spray booths are about that loud. Let's see. How noisy is 70 decibels? Noise above 70 decibels over a prolonged period of time may start to damage your hearing. There you go. So, and normal conversation is about 60 decibels. Well, that seems pretty loud too then. Yeah, vacuum cleaner or hair dryer. Or as you get up there, dishwasher. Okay. Enough about loudness though. Let's get going with this again. So I've added one dropper of clear black and then just like a couple of drops of clear brown. This is the guy notes clear brown. Let's put this kind of actually as a comparison. You can see that the clear brown or the clear brown by itself is here and the clear brown with the black is here. So this is a much, again, more brown toned clear solution. And I could probably add a little bit more black in there as well. So that one should kind of dull out anything as well. So let's do an all over of that and then see what gets us going from there. Interesting. I didn't realize it was as loud as a vacuum cleaner, but it kind of makes sense because I was like, this is so loud. And compressor is will also vary, like if you're airbrushing, your compressor is generally, like there's some pretty quiet ones, there's also some really loud ones, so I would make sure to do your research about that as well. My one is pretty quiet, all things considered. It is an Iwata Smart Jet, so it has a turn off, you know, function at 40 PSI, but when you're trying to spray between, you know, 15 to 20, it's always going to be running, so just something to keep in mind as well. Alright, that's on, and gonna turn this on now. going to just check these pieces real quick, bring a little bit more clear black if needed. Or sorry, this brown mixture. I'm already thinking of the next step, which will be just plain clear black over a few select areas. That should take us to where we're going to end tonight. Really, I was finding that after I applied that clear brown from Gaia Notes, the pieces were just a little bit too orange for my taste, so this darkening process has really helped that. And let me look at them under the light. And clear colors will blend in very nicely, so you're not going to get that spottiness or darkness. It's just going to alter the color a little bit. In this case, we wanted to change it from kind of a dullish, you know, gray pre-made mixture into more of a vibrant chocolate brown. So I think we got that at this point. And so now, let me just push this up. Let's take a quick look. So you can see it's a much richer brown now. And the shadings are still pretty dark, but they've blended in. Oh, ignore my nasty finger. They blended in, pretty nicely. It's a much darker color. But in comparison to the pants, which I will show you in just a second, it's looking very nice. So let's see. So here's kind of the color of the hair right now. See, those shadings are pretty intense, but only at certain like areas. And then the pants are here. So what looked like was super, you know, brown toned and red, or sorry, orangish, is really not at all. It's a very nice chocolatey brown compared to these pants, which are much more orange toned. So, and lighting from this angle is pretty dramatic, so really these shadings aren't as crazy in real life, just something to note. Okay, so let's do clear black, and that should be where we end this tonight. I will be taking off the masking tape for the face later, just because I want to be really careful with it, and I do have to wait for the paint to dry a little bit before I do that, so I don't think we'll have time tonight to wait for it to come off. Oh, and then after we finish this, I'm going to compare it to the skin tone as well, so. Okay, let's see, 2:30 a.m. and your D&D group is starting. Shouldn't have gone in. Oh, good lord. Do you ever sleep, Mr. Freaky? Or do you work like a night shift where you're able to like do stuff and operate on this West Coast, East Coast, USA schedule? That's pretty intense. And let's see, how far are you from my time zone then? Let's see. Oh, thank you, Pastel Storm. Nice to see you in here. We are working on it. It's getting there, but we're getting pretty close to the end here. You're a mature student. Well, I am too, so I'm there with you. Yep, going back to school, getting stuff done. Always, you know, even if you're learning from this tutorials, you're still a student. So I'm here to help you all, or whatever. I'm getting delirious. It's also very hot up here. My AC shut off, and so it's hot. Alright, let's do this clear black. I'm going to focus this mostly on previously shaded areas and just kind of go all over things to darken it a little bit more, because Chun-Li's hair is quite dark. Again, here's the reference. It is kind of chocolatey, but it's mostly darker tones. So we're just going to darken everything up. Okay, make sure that my camera does not fall off because things are moving around. I'll make this smaller. Audio is still going, so that's good. And I think we're good to go. Alright, one last time, guys. Gonna turn this on. just gives you like a darker, richer, smokier color, which you normally can't get with an opaque black because it just kind of goes on and coats everything. So this kind of lowers the crazy saturation of colors but still keeps them nice and rich. So let's take one final look at the pieces, and then I think we're pretty much good to wrap up tonight. This will basically conclude airbrushing from what I can remember, because we've painted all the pieces at this point, so all that will remain is the detail work. So we'll be able to switch back into our normal setup, or I guess both are normal, but the other side of my desk where we do our, you know, hand painting and stuff like that. But before that, let's take a look. Nice rich colors. Looking a lot more chocolatey and a lot less red compared to that initial spoon. So this was our base color spoon, remember, and the color we started out with. This is the finale. So it is shaded and darker, but you can still see some elements of it, you know, in these highlighted areas. Thank you, Pastel Storm. I try. So we're always learning, right? So there are certain things that, you know, I still have no idea about, and so we try to test our limits here. But this is a lot darker, a lot nicer than, you know, the base color. I don't know where I was going with that. Yeah, it really is pretty rich in real life. Still, you know, not super bright. Once we get a gloss coat on here, it'll be really crazy. I'm trying to compare it to my spoon, and it looks like a pretty close match. So there is a little bit of blushing you can see around the sides as we turn it, but for the most part, this color was pretty much exactly what I wanted. I did make it a little bit lighter at certain areas just to kind of bring out the highlights. Once this, you know, figure's twin tails are in, you'll really be able to see it. So we did want to kind of create a gradient here. Let's see on this one. So her head here is the most important part in my opinion, because it is attached to the skin. You can see her skin shining through here, so I think we did a good job, but we'll just have to see once the hair comes off, or the face masking comes off. Looks pretty good. Shadings are definitely present, which is something that I typically don't do very much on with hair. Like, I need to go get better about applying strong shadings to hair, so this was also a test for me. Oops, so I dropped this piece. And another important part of this is making sure that her front hair piece matches the back hair piece. So, you know, these are two separate pieces, but they're supposed to be attached. So we did want to make sure that everything kind of blends together and looks good. And it seems, you know, pretty good. Seems like there's a lot of shading going on here. I didn't do quite as much shading as I normally would with like front hair and bangs. Mostly because this piece is so small, you're not really gonna see that much of it. Oh yeah, let's also compare the piece to this. You can see that it's quite dark compared to this vibrant blue, but mostly because this blue is so crazy. It is a very bright blue, and that is the Chun-Li metallic blue that we were looking for. So let me lay out these pieces together, and so then you can kind of see the tones and the colors and see how they go together. So there you go. That's mostly the color scheme we're going to be having, along with some white in there. But it's very interesting to see how, you know, one color looks not so great compared with, you know, just one color, but when you put in everything together, it really becomes like a cohesive piece. So I did leave her hair a little bit lighter than I think Chun-Li's hair typically is, but mostly I just wanted to practice on browns and see, you know, what kind of shades and colors I can get. So especially these two, I really like them together. You can see these two, but this piece is not glossed yet, so these two here are glossed, and so they're looking like really vibrant and bright. This one not so much yet. So once we get a gloss top coat on here, you know, it'll be more representative of the actual color that it is. But also one thing to note, while I remember, is that I did lose
tiny hair tendrils that are like on either side of her bangs. You can see in this photo, she's got those two little hair things coming out near her ears. I don't know where I put those. I think they fell in the trash or something. There's another good picture of them. And so I will have to, in my spare time, cut some little paper or something and airbrush those the same color. Luckily, it shouldn't be too big of a deal because I already have these pre-made mixtures and everything, you know, is written down. So it'll only take a little bit of time. But I just did not have time to do this recently, and it's not super big concern on my mind. Also, looking at that, she's got like these little strings or something that come out of her head too on the side. I don't know how the sculptor got those because they weren't included with the kit and I don't remember them, you know, at all. And so maybe we'll just have to cut those out with paper or something and apply them too. So that pretty much sums up what we're going to do tonight. Did a lot of hair shading, so thank you for those of you sticking all the way through, even though there wasn't quite as much talking this time. From here on out though, there will be lots of talking because we are done with airbrushing at this point and we'll be moving back to the other side of my desk to paint details. So I'm expecting to look over all of the pieces next time. That will be Thursday. Much better day to do streams for me. So I'll be a little more relaxed. So we'll do all the looking over and seeing if there's any pieces I need to clean up. And if not, we're just gonna jump straight into the face and face painting. So that is a multi-step process. I'm not sure how far we'll get because looking at her face, there's not too much we can do other than like get the eyes started and whatnot, but we'll play around. Maybe I'll add another kit in that I'm working on in the moment. And there's always building to do. But yeah, thanks for tuning in. I hope to see you guys next stream on Thursday the 2nd. Thanks so much. Yeah, thank you, Pastel. Thank you, Rebel Star. Hope you guys have a good rest of your night and a good hump day. Thank you, Hololive. And I will talk to you guys soon. Have a good one. Bye-bye.